and welcome back to our channel. So today we are back with a brand new vlog, but in today's video we're actually going to be, well, it's actually going to be just me and Jack. So me and Zeliha decided just during like the rest of lockdown that we would do separate vlogs, just because it's so much easier and we thought it'd be a little bit different from what we've been kind of giving you guys, I guess, during the first half of lockdown. If you can hear a noise in the back, sorry, Jack's just making a coffee. So yeah, in today's vlog, it's actually just gonna be bringing you guys along on what me and Jack get up to, within a lockdown day. I'm not too sure generally what we're gonna do, but we are planning to go out and just have a nice day and just try and feel a little bit normal, let's say. So yeah, so we both like not long since woken up, both got showered ready, and yeah, I'm actually wearing this set from Pretty Little Thing. It's this ribbed cardigan you may have seen in the Pretty Little Thing haul that we just posted. It comes with matching bottoms, which I'll show you guys properly in a long mirror in a second. But yeah, we're both gonna have breakfast now because I'm absolutely starving.
Hello,
everybody.
Okay guys, so we've just got our breakfast. I opted for Shreddies today. And Jack, you went for brown plates?
I've gone for, yeah, brown plates. I was going to say all brown because I normally eat all brown, but brown plates is pretty much the same. Bit more crunch.
I prefer brown plates, but yeah. I've been having that every day, so today I've decided to have Shreddies. And
we've both got Yakults as well.
We have. And we both love an orange juice in the morning, so that's what we got as well. Also, what an antibiotic, which I need to take as well, which is annoying, but you know, what can you do?
We're gonna have our Yakults first.
We're gonna have our Yakults. We've been taking these because we're just, you know, trying to bring a bit of health.
Yeah.
And these are meant to be really good for you, actually, so.
Yeah, it's like,
It's weird taste, do you agree?
Sweet, very sweet.
But then watered down.
But then it makes it feel healthy.
Should we cheers it?
Cheers.
Cheers. Are you shotting it?
No, I'm enjoying it. I actually quite enjoy the taste. It reminds me of a child because I used to have these every day as a child.
Really thirsty. I think I should have got water as well.
It's as if I should have told you about yesterday's events, but we had quite a late lunch, probably about 3 p.m.
Yeah.
We tend to, when we have a late lunch, we don't really get hungry for dinner. Well, I'm always hungry regardless for dinner. Basically, it got close to like 7:30. I was like, we need to really have some food. You know, we actually have a few HelloFresh dishes left. Thought, let's make one of them. She really wasn't fancying it. She said, come on, let's just have a sweet day. Let's just maybe get a Ben and Jerry's, that kind of thing. So I had Ben and Jerry's and then had about 3/4 of a tub, finished that. And then I was like, oh my God, I'm still hungry. But then I'd already had sweet, but I'm already hungry. So what do? You add more sweet? No. So I actually opted for toast. I had 4 slices of toast. Didn't have much to go with it. So I dipped it in hummus. And then after that, I then had a bit of bitter, like dark chocolate as well. And yeah, it was a really odd mix. And I went to bed with like really bad like indigestion. I was still hungry. I was like, oh my God, it's only like 9 o'clock. And literally all I've had is just junk. And like, I would never do that again. So what I would probably normally do is actually have dinner. And then if I'm hungry, then finish off with something sweet. Don't start with something sweet because then you can't go back on yourself.
It's because we had lunch, and I had a big lunch as well. I had a chicken salad with rice, 2 chicken like breasts, breaded breasts. And it was really nice. It was very filling at 3 o'clock, which was a very late lunch. That was our own fault.
Yeah.
So then usually we have dinner about 6-ish, and I was just not hungry 3 hours later. And then when 7 o'clock came around, I was like, should we just have dessert? Like, I feel like I'm ready for dessert.
Yesterday was completely right off. I'm now glad that we're starting today normally.
Yeah.
Nice breakfast, we'll get a nice lunch and we'll have a nice dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Get some structure.
I want to make a reel with you.
Yeah.
Should we do that today?
Yeah.
Let's make a reel.
Mm.
Have a nice day.
I've never done a reel before, so I'm interested to see the behind the scenes of a reel as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought the milk. Hold on. And then eat my Shreddies. Do you know what I mean?
Is that what you normally do?
I think so. With Shreddies.
So you actually eat the Shreddies last?
So I'll go like this.
Alright.
Looking at me in disgrace. Why? Just sucking the milk out.
Just that it's funny to watch from a distance. Because you're like, if you was like in a public place.
Well, I wouldn't do it in a public place, would I?
Like going for your hotel breakfast.
Okay, so I've just received this parcel and also an ASOS parcel, which I think I know what's in that. I have no idea what's in this. I thought I'd just open it on cam and also in front of Jack.
Oh,
what will it be?
Well, I'm sure the ASOS order is lots of clothes.
Okay. I actually ordered some dresses.
Yeah,
I want to make a reel.
Yeah.
Some spring, summery dresses, because clearly I can't wait for summer. Right then. Oh, I know what it is. It's you know the My Little Coco range?
Yeah.
They sent me some stuff over. That's so cute. Wow, the box is massive. So it's Rochelle Humes, if you guys know who she is. I actually loved her from the Saturdays, and she's come out with a range, as you can see. It's called My Little Coco, and I thought it was so cute. Actually, when they reached out to me just before, I had bought a baby mask. I literally thought it was so cool, so I wanted to try it out, and it was so nourishing. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yeah, I'd definitely try out some more stuff. I like the packaging, do you?
Yeah.
Oh no, I ripped it. Oh, I might as well rip it down.
I mean, that was, yeah. Yeah, it's cute.
It's really nice, classic looking. It says, to Aisha, Happy Mother's Day. Oh, that's so cute. Really like the colour tones of everything. Aww, let me show you guys. So this is what I received in my parcel. So I've got this, which I really like the bag as well. How cute is all this? Honestly, it's so nice. So this has the bump butter in it, the bath soap, and the bump sheet mask, which I've tried and I really liked. But this bag is going to come in handy as well. I really like it. It says Baby Mama on it. That's so cute. And then we've got this. Do you want to open that for me?
Sure.
Whilst I show the rest. And then we've got this, which is nipple balm. And then we've got the bath soak here as well. I'm going to smell it. I'm going to guess it's all coconut, but I am going to smell it in a second. See what that smells like. What was in there? Oh my God, that's so cool.
That pregnancy candle.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
That's so cool. Look at that booty.
Just like you, babe.
And then we've got this hoodie, which I flipping love. That is so cool. It says My Little Coco, Baby Mama on it. And this literally calls my name on a daily basis. What do I love wearing, babe?
Neutrals.
Hoodies. Casual wear.
I was going to say, well, neutral hoodies.
This is so nice.
Yeah.
Oh my God, thank you so much to the girls at My Little Coco. Like, honestly, this is so lovely, and it's a Mother's Day gift. Cute.
I'm
gonna smell it. I'm generally guessing it's coconut, but.
Oh, I could wear this hoodie.
Let me smell it. I'm like standing my legs open, so I'm in shock. Ooh. Oh, wow, that smells lovely. It's not as coconutty as I thought. But it smells lovely, babe. Just it.
Mm. So what's this? Oh, bath soap.
Yeah.
I love
this little bag. I'm actually, this is going to be so handy for me.
Baby mama.
You know when the baby comes as well, just to put some bits in there.
Your baby mama.
Be your baby mama.
What? Oh, this is unisex. Okay, so it comes in a size large.
Yeah.
So which is obviously good.
You can share it if you want to wear it as well.
Feels good.
Oh, that was so nice to receive this morning.
Yeah, really nice. Especially like with the run up to Mother's Day.
Remember, yeah, Beauty Bay actually said, did I want to receive something really exciting? And I was like, okay. I had no idea what it is. So let's have a look inside. It comes in a massive box. I can't lift it out without, oh yes I can. Just try, Aisha, just try. Oh, right, let's see. Hey you, we thought you deserved a treat, so we're gifting you some beauty goodies for your next self-care sesh. It's super important to look after yourself now more than ever. So set some time aside to enjoy a little pamper on us. Love, Beauty Bay. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my God, I feel really happy this morning. Like, I've just received the most beautiful parcels. So, okay, wow. A lot in here, guys. So we have this range here, which is it the Beauty Bay range? I feel like it's the actual Beauty, yeah, it's the Beauty Bay range. And you get the rebalancing and refreshing cleansing gel, which sounds cool. And then we have the calming serum. Sounds a bit of me. I love anything that's calming for the skin. It's got mushroom in it. How cool. And then we've got the moisturizer again. This is meant to hydrate the skin and protect the skin. That's cool. I didn't even know Beauty Bay did their own skincare. And then we have a Revolution candle. Ooh, let's smell this. Ooh, that smells so nice and like fresh. That's cute. I'm sitting down, sorry, because my back started to hurt. And we have a face mask here as well, which is the Vitamin C Glow Boosting Paper Sheet Mask. It's from the range Yes 2, which I've actually tried before. So that's cool. You can never have too many face masks. I've got some slippers here. Handy. Love that. And then we have these. Oh my god, that's so cool. What's this? Oh, it says mum to be. Oh my god, I freaking feel like a mum this morning. That's so cool. I've got a mum to be lolly. Love that. Oh my god, and I think this actually goes up on Mother's Day, so it's perfect. And then we've got this brush set, which is cool. And then we've got, I think, a palette, an eyeshadow palette. Oh my god, that's so cool. And that is so nice of Beauty Bay to send that out to me. Thank you so much, Beauty Bay, for sending that as well. That's just so lovely and so nice to receive. Honestly, it makes me so happy. It really does. You guys will know that I'm obsessed with the Becca Skin Love foundation. Come and shop, babe. You guys know I'm obsessed with the Becca Skin Love foundation. Oh, sorry. And yeah, they're like not stocking it anymore.
And like, you know, I've seen you wear other kinds of moisturizers and it just never looks the same. Like, you always look the best in Becca. Oh, it's a foundation.
Not again. You know it's a foundation.
What did I say? Moisturizer. Well, I mean, to be fair, the thing I like about Becca is it's not just good for the beauty, it's also good for the skincare as well.
You so listen!
Anyway, carry on.
Yeah, no, that was generally explaining to Jack this morning. I said, the thing I love about Becca so much is not just the foundation, it's actually really good for your skin as well. And you guys know how much I rave about the foundation. So I've come to terms, I literally didn't want to do this, but I've come to terms with having to stock up, but only knowing that they're going to last me a certain amount of time, because obviously... Yeah. Makeup doesn't last forever, so.
So you need to look for some alternatives.
I'm gonna try on the way.
I mean, I recommended something called NARS, don't know if you guys know.
And, he went to me, babe, why don't you try NARS? I was like.
I watched this thing on TikTok about these 15 different foundations and it said that NARS was the best. It's like, try NARS.
Yeah, no, and to be honest, I don't know, again, if you're a long time viewer, you'll know that me and Zeliha was obsessed with NARS Sheer Glow and I used that for so long, for years.
Yeah.
Let's head out now. We'll take you guys along with us and...
Let's get a haircut.
Chop, chop, chop. I can cut it. He won't let me cut
it.
I said I could cut it for him.
My hair appointment is in...
Have you got your, yeah, you're like the first day, isn't it?
It's 8 a.m. on the 12th of April.
Yeah, Jack's literally everything is a haircut and my everything is eyelashes. So I've booked in, hopefully I can get it on the week of when lockdown is, like, you know, lifted. But I said to Jack, it's crazy, I'll be 31 weeks laying there getting my eyelashes done. And I don't feel the comfortable as laying down. So
I just worked out. It was middle of December when I got my haircut, so it's been 4 months since I've had my haircut.
You know what? I fell in love with you with your hair like that. And I still like your hair like that. You give me JB vibes.
No, it needs a trim.
And if you've ever watched Angus Thongs and Perfect Snogging, which is one of mine and Zelia's absolute favourite childhoods, if I feel down, I'll watch that. He reminds me of what's the boy called? Basically the one that is friends with the two twin brothers. The friend that she ends up dating, just to kind of make the other guy jealous.
I've not watched that film.
You should, it's my favourite film.
Yeah.
My all time.
And then the song goes, doom 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 doom. I don't know how it goes, but
yeah, I know which one you're singing.
Yeah, so I was singing, you didn't get it.
Girls and then boys and in love and then. Know which one I mean. But do you know what my favourite song from that is? She's a lovely, she's a lovely, she's a lovely. I think that's why I found my love of Scouting for Girls as well.
Yeah, I used to like it, to be fair.
But yeah.
Right, let's go.
We've got completely different taste in music, guys.
Yep.
We'll be in the car, and I would much rather be listening to Jonas Brothers, Justin Bieber, James Arthur, that kind of vibe. No, Jack absolutely loves, name an artist.
Well, I like all kinds of stuff. Like
you like rap? He loves rap. And I remember he was really shy to show me that you liked rap. I was like, why?
I think when we first met, I'd put like really nice lounge music on, yeah. Something that was very like
when we first
gentle.
Met, yeah, you're right. You'd always play really calming, relaxing music, which you still actually like.
Yeah, yeah.
Jack likes this music.
I'm
to
calm going from music. One extreme to another, I guess.
I'm wearing this on top, which I feel like it's like green galore. I don't really want to wear a coat. I just rather wear like a bomber. What are you doing? I don't get it.
Decorating the Christmas tree.
Oh, you're wasting the freaking paper. Here. Don't, Jack, you're wasting.
How am I wasting it? Because I'm going to reuse it now.
Yeah, we will be using it. Right.
You do look like a tree.
Do I look too, like, dressed in green?
No, I love it. What shoes are you going to wear? Have you got any green shoes?
My trainers. No, it's not funny. Should I not wear it?
No, I love it, honestly.
It's just because I don't want to wear a coat. You know
what
you
I literally found, I just bought the perfect top for your picture. Are you ready? All right, let's set you up.
If you're taking
right, guys, if you see this
if you're
take, Instagram,
if you're taking the mic, I swear. I'm not wearing this on the Instagram
ready?
Post.
So get into the pose. And then put your hand out for the prop. So whether it's a Starbucks cup or it's a... See, what I like about this is you've got three shades of green. You've got like a sort of emerald... Not I don't know emerald, I don't even know my greens. But basically you've got a light green, a mid green and a dark green.
I could bite into it.
Yeah, and then you can have your Starbucks in the other hand.
With the green logo
yeah,
showing.
Yeah, and then you could... And then you could the tagline could be go green.
Go. It could be go. Because yeah, this is a light.
Yeah.
Right, no, babe. Thanks. Oh, I think I've got. No, I didn't.
Maybe if we take a couple's picture, I could wear red and you could wear green.
And then our baby.
And we could alternate. So like, we could be like this red.
Alright, babe, stop now. Right. I'm gonna be dressed in green today. Who cares? I'm just going with it because I feel like I need one of these in maybe like a beige or black or something different, but. I'm going with it. I'm going with the green tones. It's fine. Right, so I thought I'd show you guys a little bit of a better view of my outfit. So this is the rib set. It's super cute. And I also have it in black as well. Sorry, the lighting might be a little bit off because the window's just there. And yeah, this is my Christmas tree outfit. This is Jack's outfit. Want to come and show you yours? This is Jack's outfit today, guys. Doesn't he look cute? I bought him those trainers for... Christmas, actually.
Christmas. And then you also bought me these for Valentine's.
I bought you those for Valentine's Day.
And then your mum bought me this.
And then yeah, my mum bought you the sweater and the leather jacket's yours, which I know you've had for bloody years because you've got them. You've got pictures in that where you look so young.
Yeah, because leather jackets, you can have them for years and years.
You're
and
right.
It's very versatile.
Let's go. Okay, so you know I was saying to you guys that me and Jack have completely different tastes of music. So just to give you guys an idea, this is the differences between our styles of music. So this is Jack's. And I feel like you can't really like dance to this. You're just like...
Oh, she can dance to this.
You're like this. Jack does this. And then I like, and then Jack's like, ugh. I think my favourite song of the Jonas Brothers is Roller Coaster. It just reminds me of the concert when I shut my eyes. Happiness begins. Doesn't it, babe? But we swap between the two. And then this is the other type of music. Why is it so dark? So dark. Sorry, guys. I feel like I'm in Scorpios. If anyone's been to Mykonos, you'll know what I mean. Got into Cambridge. Jack was telling me that apparently this area just... Wait a minute. Here. It's called the Parker's Peace. Which... Jack likes because his surname is Parker. But yeah, I don't really know Cambridge still that very well. I'm getting to know it.
but not quite there. I am out of breath, as you guys can hear, always out of breath, and my back's hurting and I've got a little bit of cramp in my stomach. So we're starting off on a good day. But yeah, we're just gonna have a little walk around.
Sun keeps coming in, coming out.
It's a really nice day, thank God. It was actually meant to be raining, so I'm glad it's not raining at all. Yeah, we're just gonna go for a little walk. Like Jack said earlier, I wanna go into Boots and just pick up a couple of bits as well. Right, we'll catch up with you guys later. Also, really, just last thing, it also weirds me out a little bit because I remember I used to come to Cambridge like on like day trips, and I didn't know Jack clearly. And I think back and I think, oh my God, like how weird. I used to come here all the time, didn't think anything from it.
Yeah.
And now this is my hometown.
Same in Norwich, where I live. I guess. I've always had a bit of connection with Norwich, but never went quite a lot in it.
Yeah.
I actually quite like Norwich, so.
Yeah, I like Norwich. Norwich will always have a place in my heart. It's where I grew up a lot as well. But yeah. Went into Ben's Cookies, which is my favourite cookies, and it hasn't been open. Apparently they just opened today, so I was like, let's get some cookies.
And then you asked, you said, oh, when did you open? He said, oh, today. He says, it feels really strange. I've not baked a cookie in 3 months. So hopefully these aren't the first batch. Yeah, exactly.
But I love Ben's Cookies. If you haven't tried them, I do recommend. Okay, so we've now come to this place called Aromi, which is basically an Italian, and we're going to get some lunch from here.
This is where we get our gelato from.
Oh yeah, this is where we get my ice cream. Well, we both get ice cream.
Stracciatella, which is basically like a vanilla ice cream with chocolate chips.
Yeah.
And I go for pistachio. I love pistachio.
Would have gone like with my pistachio outfit.
Oh my God, I was going to say you look like pistachio. You're a mix of pistachio and pesto.
Lovely, that's what I like to hear. But yeah, if you can see the food over there, it all looks insane. So
yeah, it looks like focaccia bread. It's like really soft and so Italian.
Yeah, so we're going to try that. I've just taken a picture down one of these alleyways because it's just so windy. Jack's like, your hair's going all over the place. I'm like, have you seen yours?
Yeah, at the end of the day, I'm not trying to take pictures.
But yeah, so it keeps spitting every now and then. That's why I've got my hood up and I'm just cozy. Guys, look how insane all of this looks. So I opted for this one here, which looks really, really nice. And then Jack went for this one.
Everyone's gonna have this as well. It has like similar.
Why didn't you try it then?
No, I did. I went for that as well.
Oh, and he also went for that.
Just because I have it in Milan, it's really nice. Very traditional.
So yeah, it looks lovely. And then the ice cream that we usually have is just here, which is also really nice as well. So if you live in Cambridge, I recommend.
Sue is also my favourite dessert, and that is literally the best I've had in Cambridge.
Oh, is it? If you like tiramisu, Jack said that's the best in Cambridge. Okay, so we're just in Boots now, and our lunch was delicious. Got a Kit Kat, and I actually just want to pick up a couple of things whilst we're here. Did you enjoy your food? Super stuffed now, aren't you?
That's the worst thing with bread.
Yeah, well, you did have two. And I fancy a Kit Kat. I literally never fancy a Kit Kat. Okay, so we've literally been sitting in the car for the past 5 minutes maybe. We have this habit where we pull up the car in front of the house and then we both just sit in the car for a while before getting out. Does anyone else do that? That's what we do. There's Jack on his phone. But yeah, and also because I've just stopped as well, like obviously when you're sitting in the car, I've had a minute to just chill.
Oh,
and
I feel tired.
We're both absolutely shattered now. We've done a lot of walking and
a lot of eating.
And now I've come over really tired, and to be honest, I feel like the past two nights, or actually the past few nights, I've not really had the greatest sleep. So yeah, my sleeping's just getting a little bit messed up as well. And actually, apparently during pregnancy, that happens, I think I heard. But my sleeping pattern, don't know, I keep waking up around 3 o'clock in the morning. And sometimes I go back to sleep, which is great. And then sometimes I stay up and then fall asleep about 7:30 and then sleep for another hour. And then I'm tired. So I'm trying to get as much sleep as I can, because every pregnant friend, or every friend that's had a baby, or just generally a lot of people go to me, enjoy your sleep now because you're not going to get much sleep. And it makes me laugh because everybody says that to me. But yeah, I am kind of one of those people though that when I am tired, I can still do stuff. Like, I'm one of those people, once I'm up, I'm up. Like, I don't know, I can do stuff. I have good energy in a way, but I don't know, I guess pregnancy is different, and obviously when you have a baby it's different, so we'll just have to see. But it will all be worth it. So yeah, like I said, we're just chilling in the car. Probably should get out. I feel like all my makeup's come off all around my nose. I think we're gonna sort ourselves out for a little bit. I'm gonna put the battery on charge, and I think we're gonna do this reel, and I'll show you guys behind the scenes of us trying to do this reel. Hopefully it comes out good. If it does, hopefully it should already be up on Instagram. So if you don't follow me and Zeliha on Instagram, go and check it out. Okay, so, sorry, it's a bit too bright now, bear with me. Okay, so we've just finished filming our reel, and I'm actually still in the last outfit. Jack's in his. It was actually really fun, so hopefully it should be out when this video is already up. So if you haven't checked it out, definitely go over to my Instagram and watch it, and say that you came from this video and show it some love. That would be really, really appreciated. I think we're just going to sort the mess, because it's a little bit of mess now.
Lots of different outfits.
Yeah, and then I think we're going to have a sit down and have a little bit of a chat with you guys and just update you guys with everything that's been going on recently.
Yeah.
Exciting. Okay, so we've just spent a few hours trying to sort out this reel. And unfortunately, we're not going ahead with the reel because
it's a shame, yeah.
The brightness, the exposure is just a little bit too much. Yeah. And
now it's too dark, so we're going to do it in a few days, aren't we?
We're just going to do it on Sunday or so. So hopefully you'll still see it on Sunday. Maybe, yeah. Potentially, but
a Mother's Day special.
A Mother's Day special of couples' outfits.
Yeah.
But yeah, you have practice from it, and then we worked together.
Yeah, I'd never done a reel before. It was interesting to see behind the scenes and how it all comes together, because yeah. Like, you do it on the camera, then you then put it on iMovie, mm-hmm. Then you like crop it.
I mean, some people do it on the phones as well.
Yeah, true,
depends.
True. But no, it's kind of cool.
Yeah, a bit
time. I mean, it's a bit time consuming for like, they don't realize that literally just 15 seconds, like how much actually goes into it.
Yeah.
Like all the changing of outfits, you get really, really hot. Yeah. You're changing different lip glosses, you're doing your hair. I'm changing different shoes, different trousers, different tops. It's like, wow.
But you gotta make it perfect. So yeah. That's why we're not just gonna I'm not gonna upload it for the sake
of it.
We'll
make it good.
We're gonna try it again, and hopefully it goes up. But anyways, hopefully actually you'll still be up the time this video goes up.
Yeah.
I'm hoping anyway. Yeah. So still go over and check it out. But yeah, we thought we'd take this opportunity just to kind of sit and have a little bit of a chat, catch up with you guys about the whole baby situation, and yeah, just give you a little bit of an update. So currently I am how many weeks?
26 and a half weeks, so you're 27 weeks on Monday.
Yeah.
So the third trimester is week 28, so literally
almost
10
there.
Days away. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely feeling it a little bit more now. I'm getting out of breath a bit more, and my belly's feeling a little bit bigger, and a lot of movement going on. Just like, yeah, I'm definitely feeling a bit more pregnant.
For sure.
I'd say my hormones are up and down.
Yeah.
As well. Right, so we've had quite a few questions asking about can we show the nursery, and what we're gonna do with the nursery.
So the update with the nursery then is we are literally gonna do everything from scratch.
Yeah.
So we've got painters coming in about 2 weeks' time to basically make it a blank canvas, gonna make everything all white, mm-hmm. Just in the process
of sort.
It looks
very dull in there at the moment,
yeah,
doesn't it?
It's like a sort of a greyish color at the moment. So we wanna make it pure white, really fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're gonna sort out the carpet as well.
Mm-hmm. See, the thing with this house is a lot of work does need to be done with this house. So it's literally such a slow process that we've been changing things slowly by slowly. Like the living room's now changed. We've like transformed the living room. Kitchens, it's changed quite a bit, but still not 100% with it, are
exactly.
We?
So sort out the carpet.
Mm-hmm.
And then we've ordered the nursery furniture as well,
yes,
which we've put on hold. It's all ready to be sort of sent to
delivered,
us, but obviously we want to make sure that the room itself is ready for the three-piece furniture set, which we've just bought. Very busy getting baby grows and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, from when they're born to like 3 months, different colours, different sort of materials.
Yeah,
and
materials. Basically, we've just been getting quite a few different bits and bobs, mainly clothing.
Yeah.
I do still need to get more of like the essentially kind of bits, which I will gradually get. and also more things to kind of decorate the room a little bit, because I obviously want it to look really nice and pretty for when she obviously eventually goes in there. I'm not in like a particular rush, but I think the excitement's gonna make me rush a little bit. And you know, why not? Like, I want it to look perfect and everything, even though she probably won't even realize that that's her room. But you know, I think, yeah, you just get excited. And obviously I want there to be a really pretty nursery space for her.
Yeah.
The theme that we're kind of going to go for is just very neutral. Just because I think it's...
Can't go wrong. Yeah. Pretty much very, very white.
The walls obviously will be all white.
And then what we'll do, so once everything's all painted, I think everything will all be kind of ready to go by early to mid-April. Mm-hmm. And then we'll then spend those final few months getting the accessories, putting things on the walls, shelving, all that kind of thing. But,
I know a lot of people that have already done like the nurseries and stuff.
Yeah, I think we're doing well.
I'm so jealous of like bloody paintings.
You can either start, you can either start sooner or later, but I think we're on track. No, yeah, we got the pram that you received.
Yeah, the bloody gorgeous pram from my mamas and papas that I was gifted.
So that's all good to go.
I'll just mention that because I don't want to get in trouble. But I love it. It's literally the pram that I would have picked out. Like when I saw it, I was like, oh yes, I love it.
And he was also gifted a high chair as well.
Luckily was gifted a high chair as well, which was in collaboration with Misguided and Eye Candy. So we've got a really nice high chair
and
as well.
And a bouncer as well, an Eye Candy bouncer. Not a bouncer, it's like a lounger where they basically just like sleep and you can rock them and stuff, but
if you want to see what it looks like, go over on Misguided's channel and Instagram and you'll see there's a picture of me.
So we've got a few of the core items now.
Yeah, also other products that I'm loving during pregnancy. Obviously I oil my body and cream my body every day, and I use the Mamma Mio the Mamma Mio range, which I absolutely love. So if you're in the lookout for something, me and Jack are cool. We're very, very excited to hopefully be slowly coming out.
It's gone
of,
really, really quick.
Yeah, and come out of lockdown. Considering we've been sat at home doing the same routine, you would think pregnancy would have gone super slow.
It's gone really quick.
Super quick?
Yeah, I know. I can't believe it, like nearly mid-March. It's mental.
I can't believe that when we go out and we can the shops and everything open, I'll be 31 weeks pregnant.
Yeah.
I remember when I fell pregnant and we were actually right here when we did the reveal. Like, where the hell has the time gone?
And that was just before New Year, wasn't it? Wow.
Right, so I think with Jack's legs in the background just there, I think I'm gonna end the vlog here because I honestly feel absolutely shattered now and I still need to do a bit of cleaning, but I don't really wanna be setting up the camera. I'm sure you guys might not wanna see it after probably such a longish vlog. So I think me and Jack are gonna get up, as much as this little one is not gonna enjoy that. We're gonna do some cleaning together, just get on top of things before the weekend and chill out tonight. Also, guess what I've got to watch?
Oh, you've got a lot of things. You've got that MTV pregnancy one.
Yeah.
And then you've also got Sam and Billy Fair's one.
To watch, My two favourite things to watch on a Wednesday. So I'm going to catch up with that tonight and we're probably going to make HelloFresh. No naughty eating tonight.
Right.
We're going to be good and we're going to actually have dinner. And yeah. So thank you guys so much for joining us on today's vlog.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been super fun. It's been really nice.
Yeah.
And we hope you guys have enjoyed the vlog. If you did, then please smash it a
big thumbs up.
Yes. Leave a comment down below, like I said, of any other things you'd like us to include in.
Make sure you subscribe as well.
Subscribe as well. That would mean a lot to all of us. And we'll catch you guys.
And follow the Instagram as well.
Also follow the Instagram.
AYSE_Clark and also Zeliha. Zeliha Clark as well. I don't actually have Instagram, so sorry guys.
You do, but you're very private. But yes, we'll see you guys in our next video. Thanks for watching. Bye. Guys, I just turned off the camera. And Jack just said to me, I'm not cleaning. F the cleaning. Yes, you are. Jack, we're cleaning. We've got to clean. It's life. We have to. He went, do you think I want to do that now? F the cleaning.
I took the day off work today to do all this filming.
No.
It's been a full
day.
You
took the day off today off work to hang out with your girlfriend.
Yeah.
That included filming.
Yeah, and then now that like we've just finished filming and it's 5 p.m., you now want to continue work.
But guess what? If we finish filming, sorry, if we finish the cleaning tonight, yeah. We've got a fresh house now for the rest of the weekend.
I'd rather.
Guys, please help me. All right, well, really, we'll see you later now. Bye.